Our technology, one of the things that's really unique, because we don't use chemical reagents in our processes, we have a very, very low cost structure. And so that's really important, obviously, to be a winner in any commodity business, is you got to be the lowest cost, most efficient operator. We think we can be one of those operators.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Joseph Mills. He is the CEO of International Battery Metals. And Joe, it's good to see you. How are you?
Good to be here. Thank you for having me on today.
Yeah, excited to learn a bit more about your technology and what the company's been up to. Give me a bit of background on the company.
Absolutely. So International Battery Metals has been in existence since 2018. So we're going on 7 years. We're publicly traded on the Canadian TSXV. So we are a pre-revenue company, but really excited about where the company is, and not only where we've been, where we are, but more importantly, where we're going. I was brought on by the board here about 2 months ago, so I'm eminently qualified to tell you all about it, but I am truly excited about where the company is and more importantly, where we're headed.
Yeah, Joe, what we'll talk about the technology in just a second, but as you mentioned, you've only been with the company for a couple of months. What drew you towards the opportunity here?
Yeah, no, thank you. So, I've had a 45-year successful history in the energy business. So I have run midstream companies, upstream companies, mineral companies, kind of everything in between. This will make my sixth company to take over, fourth public company. I was really attracted to IBAT, really because of its technology. Really, two things. One, the technology, but two, I'm really excited about the lithium space. I see this specifically the direct lithium extraction business, which is what we specialize in. You know, this is an emerging area. I call it really a nascent industry. Obviously, lithium has been around for hundreds of years and is used in multiple technologies and or products. But obviously, people really know it now because of batteries, right? And obviously, the growth of batteries, specifically in electric vehicles, is really driving a lot of the interest in lithium. And we don't see that changing. Quite frankly, we see it only accelerating. Obviously, you know, EV demand only will continue to grow. Data centers will continue to grow. Battery usage will continue to grow. But, you know, what we see, or what I see specifically, is the DLE, direct lithium extraction industry, that is a fairly new industry. That's a nascent industry. Most of the lithium in the world either comes from mining operations or from solars, right? Your big evaporation ponds in Argentina. Direct lithium extraction is fairly new. Now, it's been around. It's not like it's, 5 years old. It's been in use for 20 plus years. But the technology is just evolving where we're getting better and better and better at extracting lithium at a lower and lower cost price point. And for that reason, I saw a real opportunity with IBAT. I think our technology is superior. It's also very cost effective. And especially in today's price environment, lithium, as you well know, prices have, come down substantially. But we think it's at a low point. We think it'll rise here in the near term. But quite frankly, just like oil prices, we're going to be living in a pretty volatile commodity world. And so I think the low cost efficient operator is the one who's going to win. And we think IBAT could be in that, be a successful competitor in that arena.
So your proprietary technology does a number of things. It works without chemicals, which is obviously a key thing, but the recoveries are quite large as well. Can you sort of talk us through the technology itself and the recovery part of it?
Absolutely. Yeah. So I always like to lead off with, the company's been around 7 years. Our founder, Dr. John Burba, who really is well known and was considered one of the early pioneers in this space, Dr. Burba's been working on lithium extraction, specifically absorption. So our technology is an absorption technology. You'll hear about ion exchange and adsorption. Ours is absorption, which is really important. John has been working in this arena since really the 80s when he started with Dow Chemical, then he went on FMC where he helped build the first large commercial DLE plant in the world down at the Hombre de Muerto Solar down in Argentina. And that's what he considers his Gen 0. We're on Gen 2, and we think we're now trying to move to Gen 3 in terms of our technology. So again, our technology, A, is proprietary. B, our media is proprietary. We manufacture our media here in the United States. We don't have to go to far off places to obtain our material. We find that it is extremely resilient, has the properties around it are extraordinary toward recovering lithium at a very high efficiency rate. So like you mentioned, you know, we can get up to our upwards of 98, 99% recoveries of lithium via our medium and our process. B, we don't use chemical reagents in order to remove the lithium from our media. We actually just use fresh water or even brackish water is all we need, and not that much, because quite frankly, our process is very efficient at recycling the water that we use. We basically recycle about 94, 95% of the water that goes into our process. So we only need a little bit of water that we've got to bring into our process each time, 4 to 5%. And so the water usage is fairly low, but we only use water in order to remove the lithium from the media itself. So highly efficient from that standpoint.
Okay. Let's talk about ahead, next 3 to 6 months. What should people be looking at?
Yeah, so we're really excited. So I touched on it. You know, lithium prices certainly are at a low point right now. Yeah. You know, have we hit bottom? Don't know yet. But, you know, last week, lithium carbonate prices, which is really what people track, LCE, was around $8,500 a metric ton. That's low. You know, when you think about the euphoria that occurred in the lithium space around 2021, right, during the middle of COVID, obviously, there was a lot of euphoria around EVs. And so lithium prices really skyrocketed, and partly was because of COVID, but, you know, got upwards of $80,000 a metric ton. I always like to say, you know, that's akin to oil prices going to $300 a barrel. You know, that's not sustainable. So sure enough, lithium prices have come back down to really kind of historical averages. Historical average been around $10,000 a metric ton. And we think that's kind of the clearing price. Candidly, most of the big projects around the world can't make money at $10,000 a metric ton. Most were built, you know, with a view of $15,000 to $20,000 a metric ton. So we do see in the next, call it 12 to 24 months, we think lithium prices will recover, probably back to that $12,000 to $15,000 a metric ton. And we plan on being an active participant in that recovery. Because our technology, one of the things that's really unique, because we don't use chemical reagents in our processes, we have a very, very low cost structure. And so that's really important, obviously, to be a winner in any commodity business, is you got to be the lowest cost, most efficient operator. We think we can be one of those operators. So we're excited. We think we have a lot of projects in the pipeline, a lot of customers that we're talking to as we're preparing to try and capture that upswing. If everything goes well, we have a demo plant that we built that we plan on deploying. So we're beyond just the laboratory phase. We're quite frankly beyond the pilot stage. You know, a lot of our competitors talk about laboratory, going to a pilot, and then go commercial. We went from lab to building a demo plant that actually has been run. We've already generated lithium carbonate from it. So we're excited about deploying that. And we're one of the things that's very important about our technology, it is modular. What does that mean? Well, it means it's movable, right? So it's all built on skids. We can mount them on the back of trucks and we can move them. Quite frankly, from the time that we get a customer signed up, depending on where it is in the world, but let's assume it's here in the US, we can be on location and have our plant running in 4 to 6 weeks. So, you know, that cycle time is incredible. Now, if we had to build a new plant, I want to be clear, a new plant will take us about 8 to 12 months to construct, and let's call it a 5 to 10,000 metric ton plant. That's still years ahead of some of these larger plants that, you know, they're stick built, that are like small refineries. Those can take 2 to 4 years to build. We can be up and running in call it 12 to 18 months, a new project. So yeah, we're pretty excited about where we are. We think the lithium business has got a lot of upside, and we plan on being an active participant in that recovery.
Well, it looks like it's going to be a pretty busy year ahead for sure. Joe, thanks so much. Good to catch up with you and see what the company's up to. We look forward to following your story, all right?
Thank you so much. I appreciate your time.
All right, there's Joseph Mills, the CEO of International Battery Metals.